Because what's up, it's your boy, and we're going over how to create the absolute best Google My Business post on planet Earth. After watching this video, your Google My Business post game is going to be on point. Not only are we going to show you how to create the best optimized post, we're also going to show you why. And we're going to show you some awesome hacks and how to utilize them in ways you've never thought of before. Let's go! All right, guys, so before I get this started, I'm going to go over the weekly highlight reel. For all you haters out there, roll the tape, Mike.
Fuck being on some chill shit. We go 0 to 100, nigga, real quick. They be on that rap to pay the bill shit. And I don't feel that shit, not even a little bit. Oh Lord, know yourself, know your worth, nigga. My actions being louder than my words, nigga. How you sold, I been still sold down to earth, nigga. Niggas won't do it, we can do it on they turf, nigga. Oh Lord, I'm the rookie and the vet. Shout out to the bitches I ain't holding down the set. All up in my phone looking at pictures from the other night. She gon' be upset if she keep scrolling to the left, dawg. She gon' see some shit that she don't wanna see. She ain't ready for it. If I ain't the greatest, then I'm headed for it. Yeah, that mean I'm way up. Yeah, the six ain't friendly, but that's where I lay up. This shit a motherfucking layup. I been Steph Curry with the shot. Been cooking with the sauce. Chef Curry with the pot, boy. 360 with the wrist, boy. Hey, who the fucking niggas is, boy? OVO, man, we really with the shits, boy. Yeah, really with the shits. I should probably sign a hit, boy, cause I got all the hits, boy. Fuck all that Drake, you gotta chill shit. I be on my little mouse drill shit. Fuck all that rap to pay your bill shit. Yeah, I'm on some rappers pay my bill shit. All up on TV, I thought it make me richer. Wasn't paying me enough, I needed something quicker. So now I'm all in Nico basement, putting working on the phones. Either that or drive the money mark to make the pickups. Man, it's 2008, I'm trying to paint the picture. Comeback season in the works and now I'm thinking bigger. I got 40 in the studio, every night, late night. Gotta watch that shit, don't wanna make them sicker. That's my nigga, oh Lord.
All right, if you're looking for SEO services, Google PPC, hit me up. My email is below. Or if you're a marketer yourself or SEO and you just want an extra set of eyes on your campaign. And if you wanna show up in the weekly highlight reel, shoot me your results. Any tactic that I've taught you thus far, whether that's a YouTube, Facebook group, or Patreon. I thought it'd be a really fun idea to start highlighting some of these wins. I don't think us as SEOers, we give ourselves enough credit. I know I don't. So if you got an awesome win, shoot me an email or reach out to me in the Facebook group. It's probably the easiest way to get a hold of me. And if you're not a part of the Facebook group, I'm putting the link in the description below. Join it. You guys are going to miss out on some awesome content. Enough of my shameless plugs, and let's jump into it. So we're going over GMB posts, baby. I want to go over a really cool tool here called the GMB Crush tool. I know a lot of marketers that I know that are using it. Shout out to Meadow. I'm actually working with him, and they're going to be creating a new version of this that I can tell you without a doubt is going to be something special. They are trying to create the Chrome extension of all Chrome extensions for Google My Business. What I like about this tool is that it can actually show you the posting frequency of your competitors. And as you know, competitor analysis is half the game. So to download the Chrome extension, just Google GMB Crush Chrome extension and download it. All right, now, once you download the tool, all you can do is click on the Chrome extension in the top right-hand corner and go open a Google Maps search. And then we're gonna type in our keyword. So we've got plumber near me, let's just do that. Boom, now we can hit click results, let them crush it, and you'll get the data back. All right, in order to know how to create a good post, you need to understand what that post is actually doing, and that takes us to the business.site. Now, a really awesome search operator is site semicolon business.site, and then whatever your niche or niche plus city. So as you can see, I put in site.business.site, Roto-Rooter, because I wanted to look at some business sites for Roto-Rooter. And as you can see, all these are going to be somewhat related to Roto-Rooter or have Roto-Rooter on them. All right, then one for personal injury. As you can see, these are all personal injury business.site. Now, as you can see, you can always add in a city or a state as well. We put in New York, and let's see what we get. All right, all these are going to be majority New York, or Google's going to associate them with New York. So these are great ways to find a competitor analysis if you're wanting to try to reverse engineer what other people are doing inside of your industry. Because once you have the business.site, you can scrape all of the posts, and I'm going to show you how to do that right now. All right, so I found a pretty decently optimized business.site for the Napoleon accident injury lawyer, okay? So what we're going to do is we can scroll down and we can check this out a bit. They're doing a really good job at posting, which is our main category. They've got, they're reviewing testimonials. They've got a bit of an anchor text in here. Could be better, but not too bad. So we're going to over here and we're going to drop it in the Screaming Frog and we're going to scrape all those posts. Now, I don't want to bore you with all this other mumbo jumbo stuff for people that aren't like SEO gurus, like business owners, but I do want to show you two main things. Number one is going to be the headers, so we can show you how to manipulate your headers. Think on-page SEO. And number two is going to be the canonical tags. I found something really, really interesting this past week. All right, so first thing I want to show you here real quick is your H1 headers. Now, as you can see inside of Screaming Frog, these are every page, and then it shows us the H1 headers that's on each page. Now, when you create a post inside of your Google My Business listing, that post becomes its own page into your business.site, and I'm going to show you that later on, exactly what that looks like. But all your posts are going to have the same H1 header, all right? So think on-page SEO. And the way to manipulate this is if you, instead of using a regular update or an offer, you can actually use an event post, and that will actually change the H1 header. So what I've done is over here is I grabbed one of the URLs to the post, and as you can see, these actually become pages. Let me show you my URL. There's the actual URL with the post number, and you can see they've done a great job. They've got their image optimized, they've got their phone number, social profiles, URL, main keyword, looks like accident, injury, lawyer, and then they've also optimized the post. They did a really good job here. Now, I'm going to show you some really cool hacks and tricks that you can do with these Google My Business posts that you can do for your website, setting up an RSS feed, kind of thinking outside of the box here, and I'm going to show you that right now. I'm going to get into a little bit of the secret sauce, all right? And I'm going to show you a couple of really awesome ways to utilize these Google My Business posts that I guarantee you have not seen before. So first way is, I call it hot linking your GMB post to your webpage, and I'm going to show you how to do that right now. What I did is I Googled Roto-Rooter, and let's scroll down to the post, and let's just say we want to utilize this post for this technique. Okay, we're going to right click, and we are going to copy image address. Now, I don't know what kind of page builder you're using, but it's pretty much the same thing. Even if you are using a page builder, you'll know how to do it once you see it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come over here and I'm going to add a photo into... All right, next, instead of my photo source, I'm going to go to URL, and then I'm going to drop in the URL and save. Simple as that. So now your image is being hosted on your business.site that's connected to the GMB. Very, very powerful. But the second way that you can utilize your GMB posts are going to be with iframe. All right, so for this technique, I'm going to hop over back to the personal injury lawyer, and we're just going to copy the URL to the post. And then we are going to put in a iframe right here. Then we're going to copy the iframe, and we're going to drop in a piece of HTML here. We paste in our HTML, and we are good to go. And this iframes the entire page. It does not just the image, but the entire post itself. All right, let's change with the height. I don't really like the way that looks. Let's do 600 by 600. Let's see what that looks like. There we go. So as you can see, it looks a lot better that way. You can customize it to whatever fits your page best. As you can see, we've iframed the entire post, and it's got a scroll bar, as you can see here. So if we were to finalize it and somebody came on this page, they would be able to scroll up and down and see all the content. All right, the last thing I want to share with you guys is setting up an RSS feed for your Google My Business post. This is actually really awesome to do. Shout out to John Maranko for showing this in our Patreon. We talked about these things in our last live, and John decided he was going to do a complete tutorial on setting up an RSS feed, and I'm not going to steal all of his thunder, so I'm not going to really go over all the stuff that he did, so you're going to have to go into Patreon for that, but I do kind of want to show you what's possible. So here, we're going to get started. We're going to create a new feed. I'm on a free account. We're going to drop in the URL and generate. This is for the accident attorney. All right, as you see, it's popped up. We're going to save to my feeds, and there we go. Now we can come over here to an embed, and as you can see, all the GMB posts here are embedded, and we can copy the code, come over, and let's drop it in right here. Why not? Paste it. Save. All right, I went ahead and finalized everything to show you guys exactly what this looks like and get a feel for it. As you can see, we've got our image here that's hot linked to the GMB post. We've got our iframe. That's, you can literally scroll. This is really cool. And then we have our all of our post embeds. And these are set up from our RSS feed. This is cool because they link to the actual page on the business.site, which is absolutely awesome. And then the Patreon, John shows you how you can literally mix in your GMB posts with like CNN posts. Like, it's crazy. But I'm not going to go into that. You got to check that out for the Patreon, guys. All right, guys, that's it. It's your boy. I got some awesome new content coming up later on this week, so be on the lookout. Please drop a comment below. Like, subscribe. I will put the iframe template down in the video description. That's it. It's your boy. Peace.